All right, drop a comment, drop a comment. How we doing? Ready for part three? Hit that subscribe. If you already subscribed, drop a comment. Let's go. I'm learning so much. And yo, lads, let me know, like, is graffiti still a thing, like, to this day? Like, are they tagging trains? Are they tagging the bus? Are there, like, graffiti walls between blocks? Like, let me know what I'm walking into. You know what I'm saying? I just want to know. That's all. I just want to know. There they go, tagging the trains again. Stop, Oreo.
Justin, I'll put it to you that over the last 2 years you have used the tag Jizza. You're known as Jizza. And you've put up the tag or mural Jizzo. What do you have to say about that?
No comment.
Justin, you are going to be charged with criminal damage. You're not obliged to say.
That's crazy. And it's wild because it's like, if you're going to do graffiti, right? And you're going to break the law, right? But it's like, it's graffiti. You risking your freedom. So you kind of got to put your name. You got to put your tag. But it's kind of like self-snitching at the same time. But you got to put your tag. It's like, they know what they signed up for. You know, it's just, it's a risky game. But it is what it is. It's one of those games where that's how they going to get their respect.
So if there's anything, unless you wish to do so, or whatever you say or do may be recorded and given in evidence. Do you understand that?
Comment.
Do you intend to make a no comment interview?
No comment.
Right, Justin, we're going to conclude this interview. Would you agree that the time is now 13:13 or 1:13 p.m?
No comment.
Right, interview is completed.
Damn, it was 5 of them? Hold on, my door come back. That's crazy.
The only thing that went through my head when I got the knock was, right, they're here. I knew they were going to come here one day, I just didn't think as soon as they would, you know? But that's life, mate, you know?
They were knocking on the door, so I go, Justin, someone's at the door. He goes, oh no, it's them.
And as soon as I got the knock, man, I knew, because, you know, it's the hard knock. 6 o'clock in the morning, mate, what else, you know? Everyone knows that, you know, everyone knows I've got a kid in that. They wouldn't, like, ram on me door. I didn't have this locked, so they started booting it.
Dang, that's crazy. But at least he got out, you feel me? Ain't no biatch.
And I came over, And I go, chill out, cunts, and I fuck, because I had this thing over it at first, because I went like this, and I went, fuck off, dogs, and slammed it. And then fucking, then they were at that door, smashing that door, going, don't think about it. And then I fucking, I came back to this door, because he started booting it. And I fucking, I unlatched it, opened it up, and I fucking, I got rushed, man, into that corner and booted and slammed into the ground. And cuffed.
They all grabbed him and pushed him around the corner and put him down on the ground and put the handcuffs on him. And the idiot starts going, it's too tight, you're hurting my hands. And fuck you guys, you fucking assholes, come to my house. Who the fuck do you think you are?
You know, they fucking threw me around and shit in here while I was cuffed.
Shout out to him for having a little, the African American, well, I can't say American. I was about to say African American because I'm so used to saying that. But shout out to the, shout out to his lady. You know, I'm loving the dark skin. I'm loving it.
Man, what sort of a dog ties you up and then fucking gets staunch on you? You know.
But Justin kind of went about it the wrong way by telling them that, you know, that he's gonna go out there and do more damage. This doesn't mean anything to him.
Yo. Now that I know his name, Justin is a wild lad. Like, he basically told Australian police, listen, I'm still going to do me. I'm still going to tag you. I'm still going to do what I do. So, arrest me now. I'm not going to do that much time. I'm going to come out and I'm going to still be terrorizing the city. Stop, Oreo. I can't make this up.
It just makes him more.
Go sit down. You just ate your food. Like, go sit down.
Like, if they wanted to, they could have listened to that and put it down because they told him not to say anything. If he didn't want to be, if he didn't want to get in trouble for it later, and he was standing there saying he did do the damage, he was gonna go do more. He's the king of Melbourne.
You know, at the end of the day, they just waste their time and their resources on.
Oreo, don't
fuck
sit
with
right here.
Like
in the
me,
wire. How many times
do
I have to tell you that? Okay.
Stabbing
go over
cunts,
there. Stop it.
Cunts, rolling cunts, raping cunts, fucking. All sorts of the illest fucking crimes that not even a crime, they're just ill, you know, and then they come to my shack over, you know, over going all city. It's like, you know, it's ridiculous, bro. You know, they should use the government's money to fucking, you know, catch real criminals, not fucking, you know.
I agree. I don't feel like, but like I said, it is kind of, you know, you're damaging property. It is other people doing worse things, but it that's something that is like, it's annoying for the city. I can only imagine.
Not small timers like myself, mate. Where I live, there's hundreds of people.
Stop.
Selling smack, and everyone's dying, fucking looking like shit, and I fucking make everything look good, but they'll come shut me down. Yeah, I feel like a fucking gutted fish sitting on the table waiting to get cooked. It's like basically me sitting at home waiting to go to court. It's kind of good though to like. To have a break.
Yo, he stay smoking them cigs. You gotta chill with that.
But that's only from the, like, the bombing side and the stealing paint side and all the bullshit that comes with it. But the painting side, I really can't come to facts with it. I'm scared of, like, losing my family. I'm scared of getting raided again, which will be a result of me losing my family. So, yeah, I'm in a bit of a no-win sitch. No, they've shut me down emotionally, not physically. They've kind of warped my head a bit at the moment because I've got a lot to lose and I know that. Hello? Matt?
Yeah, rip south.
Yeah, I will, bro.
She wants you to ring her now, man.
All right, bro. Where are you? At the stage?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. I'll ring her now, man.
Yeah, no worries.
I'll come back to Auburn soon, man. I'm just at Eddie's house.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Yeah,
girls.
It's foggy. I'm not foggy. It's like smoky in my room. Maybe I just, I did smoke a whole blunt. I got the windows closed, so don't be so loud. But then messing with my eyes, why y'all keep seeing me vigilant?
The film in the film shop near.
Yeah, sick, man.
You're gonna get
developed. Yeah. Oh, sick, man. Sick. But I'm gonna cheat. Yeah, I'm more scared of my girlfriend than I am of DSG.
Yeah, because it's like, you got a kid now, bro. You're older. At some point, you kind of got to stop doing this, you know? Leave it for the younger heads.
Just do something that will benefit our future. Getting a fat photo album doesn't really do much for me family, except for me. I should just make another appointment now to come in and see my brief, yeah?
I'll contact you when we've got it.
Alright.
Okay.
Alright, see you later.
And it sounded like he was maturing too. He just said, if I keep putting graffiti up and all that, like, that ain't really doing nothing for the family. I was wondering, like, that does not pay bills. Like, that's just a hobby. You gotta turn that into something. Like, maybe make t-shirts, something, sell your merchandise, something. You keep doing that, they ain't gonna do nothing, put you in jail, and you're not gonna gain nothing from that. Nah, goddamn
that. That guy's a fucking tool. Yeah, I'm not gonna get locked up or nothing, even if I get found guilty of it, bro. Serious. Because the worst thing that they can do to me is give me a community-based order, and that's community work. I'm denying it anyway, man. I'm gonna get it all dropped. I said to him, I go, mate, I'm not happy with this, mate. They come to my house, give me more charge sheets, call me a dickhead in front of my family and shit. I go, don't get me wrong, mate. I know how to fucking paint. I don't fucking paint the trains that they're saying I did, mate. But if they want to fucking charge me for trains, I'll go out and fucking paint some fucking trains. Fucking trains. Trains.
Yo, you cursing mad much. Demonetize out of this video.
Trains. Right.
Because I am not about to say, I know you wondering, TT, can't you just edit it? I can, but it's like, oh goodness, I'll be having so much stuff to do. I might just edit it though. But they might demonetize the video anyway, so it don't make no sense.
I know exactly why graffiti is illegal. It's because of the fucked up world that we live in that's run by fucking money, which is a fucking train that I fucking paint is illegal because I didn't pay the fucking train company for my advertisement to run on the train. I got my advertisement for free because I'm a smart enough human to rock up and do something without paying for it. Where everyone else, because they abide by rules and regulations, all they do is give their money up and their shit runs all city, man, because they paid for it. Because we don't pay for it, our shit just gets cleaned off and we've got a bunch of rejects running around looking for us.
Uh-oh, it's getting down to the nitty-gritty. It's getting good, lads!
No, I got fucking 7 months jail, suspended for 2 years. My heart went to my fucking down to my balls, man, and then sprung back up my throat. And then she goes, suspended, and then I start breathe again. But I don't want to go there. Dude's in my crew, go, don't worry, man, you'll be all right. This dude's in my crew, old school dudes that would look after me and shit, but fuck that, what? What's the possibility that I'm gonna get sent to the same camp that they're at, you know? Fuck it, man.
I knew the judge wasn't gonna go easy on him, because you are, I mean, even though she did, because it could have been way worse, but, like, you are doing the most. Yo, is his graffiti still up to this day in Australia? Let me know, drop a comment.
Go there, mate. It's bad enough fucking living on the west side than going to fucking live in jail. Fuck that. I'm going there. I couldn't handle being around like that many boobs as well. I love crime, don't get me wrong. I love it. And I love hearing, you know, stories, this and that.
He said he loves crime. I'm weak.
24/7, day in, day out, cunts talking shit. It scares me more than anything, because I know that if I break the law, I'd go to jail if I get caught. So if anything, if I wanted to do graffiti still, if I wanted to do anything, I'm not gonna have fun doing it because it's just a constant stress. It's fucked. I can't even rack a fucking drink without a 7 months jail hanging over my head. Can't do shit, man. Because I
now he's gonna know how it feels to be a normal legal citizen, you know, not stealing stuff, being a good Samaritan.
Had
good
my
for him.
My sort of hobby taken away from me.
That is called growth.
Which I don't have any other hobbies that I wish to pursue, where it's just left me in a rut of just being like, what can I do with my life?
Stop, Oreo.
I don't like skateboarding. I don't like art for other people. I like doing my own shit. Since I got raided and I haven't been able to do graffiti and I'm really just got nothing to do, which led me to excessively smoking a lot of fucking weed, man. Which led...
Hey, I know the feeling.
...led me to detox 2 times to try and get off the shit because I was abusing my body that much. From the cops taking all my shit, and just everyone else that's getting done for graph is just getting let off, getting CBOs and shit, and I get all my shit taken, I get beaten up, and I get a fucking suspended sentence. I'm fucking... Those cunts made me lose my brain, mate. Because I'm not racking shit and that, I fucking constantly running out of money or fucking have to borrow money off my chick, and then I'll be in a rut where I'll be fucking trying to fucking ill day Ugdres and shit, and then I'll be like getting behind in that, and then I'll have to borrow money or won't be able to pay her back $50 that I owe her or something, you know? And it just causes tension. You know, I should go out and get a job, but you know, I'm on sickness benefits and I don't go out and look for work. And even though if I could get a job, I probably wouldn't even stick to it, you know, because I'm not like a normal person. I can't deal with a lot of shit a normal person can deal with. But if I wasn't on a suspended, it wouldn't be like that. But then again, if I didn't do graffiti and get in trouble, then it wouldn't be like that anyway, you know? So I've got myself to blame, and I know that.
And he found a hobby that doesn't benefit him. It only destroys him. Like, that's the thing. Like, doing that is going to forever destroy you because it's illegal. So, yep.
I'll never be over graph, man. I'm fucking a purebred, bro. Fucking meant to graph, mate. There's nothing I've ever done in my life that I've felt as comfortable as when I'm out painting, doing a piece, or scribbling on a train. There's nothing that beats that. It's the rawest art form ever. It's the rawest hobby you could be involved in. It's not like you go out there and you lose today, or you fucking, you know, you won't win, and then you know, or you get sent off the field. It's like, you fucking lose, you lose, man, that's it. It ain't no second chance shit. That's what's so real about it. If I was like everyone else, I'd live like everyone else and be a sad, matrixed out motherfucker.
Ah, yo, he was talking about the Matrix in 2005. Now, you know, like the movie and stuff like that, but like now everyone's like big on like how we're living in the Matrix, and he's talking about that like years back. That's crazy.
That wakes up every day at 9, goes to work, comes home at 5, eats their dinner, watches a bit of shitty TV, then goes to sleep and does it all over again.
Yeah, I couldn't live like that. I need the lads. That's why I do YouTube. You know, there's nothing wrong with it, though. If you got a job and it's making you happy, stay there. But me, personally, that would just drive me crazy. And I'm so addicted to weed, so, yeah.
Again, I'd rather be, you know, my own person and do what I want when I want and not have to answer to anyone. And if that means that I can't do it for what, 2 years while I'm suspended, I'm gonna have to fucking take it on the chin, man. Because to me, as much as I love graffiti, going to jail for the shit ain't worth it, you know?
Yeah, no, absolutely not.
Today I'm all-
absolutely not. So I'm glad he's gonna chill into it. But it's not like he said he's going to chill until after his sentence. But it's like, yo, bro, just don't do it. Find something else to do.
Off my suspended is the day that I start playing this game we call graffiti.
Yes, with the reject video's done. Cops say bye, Melbourne. Lads. I'm about to go. Pretty interesting video.
Wherever there's trains, there's always going to be graph. As long as you can get to the train and get 5, 10, 20, half an hour, whatever, there's gonna be shit's gonna be running, man. Because there are gonna be dudes like me out that wanna fucking do as many as we can this little time that we've got on this earth, you know? It's all about spicing your life up, you know? You can either live for 20, 30, however long, and then die. You know, you could be part of the Matrix and just have some dead-end job, work, pay your mortgage off and just die. I'm gonna do all that shit, but I'm gonna get 100 galves under my belt, you know? I'm gonna die with a fucking fat photo album there, you know? Hopefully. See how it go.
He actually talking some real talk right there. I like that. I ain't gonna lie. Stop, Oreo. I just told you to stop. Stop, stop, stop. But yeah, that's crazy. Cause he talking some real thing right there. He like, listen, you either stand for something or fall for nothing. You understand? So either you part of the Matrix or you standing up and you doing something. So me personally, I respect what he do. I respect what he did. I'm hoping and praying that eventually he got made some money out of it. Like I said, do some t-shirts, you know, do some live shows, people, you showing people how to graffiti, something, but legally, you know? Shout out to Eddie Martin. This was a dope documentary. Hit that subscribe for the vibe. Make sure you watch all parts.